Story 1. My first love taught me how to love my wife by teaching me that love means honoring and respecting the relationship as an entity and valuing the person who gives that gift to you and makes it work every day. She taught me this by doing none of those things and by making their lack glaringly obvious in the last days of that relationship. I'm glad to have had her. I fondly remember the feelings she gave me. I'm eternally grateful she's gone and my wife is here. Story 2. Life is a choose-your-own-adventure book. If I had married her, I would have lived in a different part of the country and maybe had a different career path. I might likely have been divorced, too. Ultimately, I could have been happier or more miserable. Fortunately, life isn't a multiverse like a Marvel movie, so I'll never know. Story 3. My current wife knows of and has met my first love. I am significantly better with my current wife than I would have been. I only tell my wife it's significantly better. I don't want her too comfortable. Seriously, I think about the past at times, but definitely do not want that now. It's like remembering a fun time when you were 20 but absolutely never wanting to be 20 again. Story 4. I sometimes think about past partners, but never in that way. More just, I wonder if they're okay, because most of them were nice people who I used to care about. Story 5. There's no point in thinking that because those thoughts are fiction. The mind creates an idealized scenario. Stop dwelling on what could have been and focus on what is in front of you. Story 6. My first I saw on Facebook. She is a nice person. She is married well and has nice looking kids. She still looks exceptionally beautiful and has aged very well. Second one, man. She looks like she's had a tough time. I would walk past if I saw her on the streets. I don't think much of either. I don't live in the past. I am happy where I am. And the question would be, how would things be different if I wasn't with my current love? That is a far scarier thought. Story 7. It's weird. I've literally just mentioned this in the Am I Overreacting subreddit. But yes, I do. We were very young, got together at 11 years old, and split at 16. The reason being her parents thought us being together would limit her opportunities after leaving school, like she'd turned down university places too far away or she had considered the Navy, etc. If we were together, her parents thought that would mean she'd not take those opportunities to stay with me. We had a conversation 6 years later. I was with my current partner then and expecting our first child. My ex explained her parents pressured her into separating. She said she had always loved me, still thought about me, etc. We were both in the same position, really, both with new people, our time had passed. Ironically, she didn't take those opportunities because she had stayed around holding out hope we'd get back together. Out of respect for our current partners, we've not been in contact since. I hear updates every now and then as we have mutual friends. By all accounts, she is happy, married with 4 children, and has a nice house. And I am happy as well. I love my partner, our children, and my life. Every now and then, I do think about her though and how different things would have been if she had stood up to her parents. Story 8. My first serious girlfriend was and still is a train wreck. We would either be divorced or still painfully married because it's the right thing to do. But if I'm entirely vulnerable, part of me wonders what it would be like to have kids that don't have a genetic disease. 2 of my 3 kids have cystic fibrosis, which was really scary and stressful when they were very young. There were times when I was trying to process that I may live longer than my children, and in those times I wondered what it would be like to have lower maintenance kids, but then I remember all that stress would be picked up by a high maintenance wife. Fortunately now, with medical advances in treatment, cystic fibrosis is more manageable and a little less scary and stressful. Story 9. I think of her fairly often, perhaps every 6 months or so. The context is that she basically disappeared from the face of the earth. I honestly just wonder what happened to her, hoping she is super happy and has had a great life. For reference, she was 15 to 16 the last time I saw her. Story 10. No, I don't think about my exes much at all. There were reasons they didn't work out, and there are even more reasons my spouse and I did. I don't hold anything against them, and I don't have any particular regrets. Source: Married 14 years this October. Story 11. My first love? No, that was in 7th and 8th grade. First serious love, sure, I married her. I sometimes wonder how things would have gone with some crushes, but I am okay with where I am. Story 12. I met her when we were both still too young to be in a long-term relationship. Or at least I didn't know what I wanted out of life or a relationship, and I certainly didn't know how to be a good partner. While I learned a lot about both, I still had a lot more to learn. She started to pressure me into thinking long-term, which made me realize I wasn't ready. It was a pretty heartrending goodbye. We stayed in touch for a while. I know she eventually got married and had some kids. I sometimes still wonder about what could have been. I think there was a chance we could have made it work. But looking back at my journey since then, I'm very thankful for all that I've learned. I've met many people who first taught me about what I didn't want from a relationship. Later, I learned a lot about how to care for others. I have since met a wonderful woman, and we've been married for more than a decade now, and I'm still learning. Story 13. The only version of my life I want to think about is the one with my kids in it. They drive me bonkers and take all my energy, but they are my reason for sticking around. Story 14. I do not constantly think about it, but I do marvel at how incredibly lucky I am to be with the woman I am now. If I were still with the girl I first fell in love with, my life would be so chaotic, crazy, and unfulfilling, it is not even funny. The fact that I am who I am with now is just insane to me. She is the perfect partner for me, and I cannot even imagine how troubled I would be now if I were still with my first love, who started doing crack and becoming involved with like 20 other people. It is weird how something like that can be the singular worst thing and the best thing that has happened to you in your life. I am so grateful that happened. Story 15. Not my first love, no, but I reached a point in my life where I had the choice between settling down with my would-be wife or a girl who was more fun and free-spirited. I always look back and wonder how different my life would have been if I had chosen the other girl. It's a choice that has loomed over me, not because my wife isn't great, but because it was such a pivotal moment in my life. It would have loomed over me the other way if I had made the other choice. Story 16. Hello, original poster. I am a 48-year-old married father of two in the United Kingdom. Not in the slightest, because right in front of me there's the absolute smoke show of my wonderful wife who's had two of my kids and somehow gets sexier every single day. That's a no for me, friend. Story 17. I'm the first love that all the married men contact. So, I can tell you that they do, in fact, delude themselves into thinking everything would be different. We message on Facebook for a bit, maybe have a phone call or some emails, and slowly it becomes apparent that this guy is unhappy and has been fixated on me, his high school fantasy, for decades. However, it's just a fantasy. I've had Republicans call me, thinking we were the perfect match, whereas I can't stand to talk to a Republican for longer than 5 minutes and only then if I'm under duress. I've had religious, church-going guys call despite the fact that I'm an atheist. I can't remember all the guys I dated in high school who, out of the blue, suddenly decided, against all odds, that I was the one after all. Why? Because I can be anybody inside their heads. They can ignore all the annoying real parts of me that don't fit into their fantasies. Another reason is that I was a bit of a manic pixie dream girl in my youth, so they think I'm still out there making life magical. Sensible men in happy marriages don't seek me out. If our paths cross, they aren't secretive and dramatic about it. It's just this subset of men who aren't wise enough to realize that someone you dated briefly in high school was just a fantasy and not the solution to all your problems. Story 18. She came out during college and eventually married a woman. So I do not think it would have worked out so well for either of us. I do think about one of my other post-college girlfriends and think that could absolutely have worked out had I been more mature. Story 19. Yes, all the time. About how lucky I am that I married my wife and not her first girlfriend or any other girlfriend. Everything happens for a reason. So corny but so true. Thinking of what might have been is an impossible road to nowhere. Look forward to a bright and happy future that you control. Story 20. I think about my first girlfriend sometimes and how it would have been different. Different mostly in bad ways, laugh out loud. My wife makes me happy in many ways that my first girlfriend would not. She loves far more openly and freely, isn't commitment phobic, is more conventionally attractive as the phrase goes, and is more sexually active. My first girlfriend never did get married. No other man could get through her emotional walls either. My wife basically has nothing to worry about. Story 21. I bumped into her a month or so ago out of nowhere at a random coffee shop. She lives in another state. We talked for about 15 minutes just to catch up. She's married now and has a baby girl, and I'm very happy for her. She said at one point that she doesn't think we were wrong for each other, just that we met at the wrong time. I think that's probably true, but it doesn't make me wish things were any different. I'm glad she's happy, and I'm happier than I could imagine with a woman who loves me so profoundly. Story 22. Certainly, here is the revised version of the text suitable for Azure Text-to-Speak AI. OP, you may enjoy this poem, The Road Not Taken. Story 23. Yes, and simply being dedicated to your current marriage because it is way better is a dangerous reason. What happens when your current marriage becomes difficult and or on the rocks? That first love will look a lot better. Personally, I do miss my first love sometimes, but what I really miss is that time in my life. There are two thoughts here. One, my feelings for my first love are based on nostalgia and the perspective from myself as a teenager. Two, I made vows with my wife, and I am committed even if it feels bad at times. Would things be better if I married my first love? Maybe. Who knows? Why does it matter? Anyone who gets married because of feelings will end a marriage because of feelings. It is not a good reason to do either, in my opinion. Story 24. Once in a while. Mostly in either the context of, I'm glad I didn't marry that, or they taught me things that made me a good husband to my beloved wife and I'm grateful. Story 25. She always wanted to marry someone in the military so she could continue living her military brat life into adulthood. I was not in the military, so it would have never led to marriage. She also had mental health issues I did not want to deal with. She met a sailor and then constantly filled her social media account with posts about being a proud dependent and living the life of a sailor's wife. I do not have any feelings for her, so looking back, I was indifferent. Story 26. Would have ended up divorced. We did not have the same long-term goals, and while I was willing to compromise, she was not. Life for me is very good and has been for many years. Married happily for 33 years, own our home outright, no debt, travel often, and have money in the bank. Story 27. My first love was a neighbor girl who came from a broken home, smart and full of compassion. Indeed, things would be very different with her. My love for her was innocent, and I never found out if she felt the same for me. Her loyalty was to family, though, and that led to a lot of trauma. She is a different woman now than the girl I knew. My first woman, a sexual partner, and first girlfriend. Things would indeed be very different. Valedictorian of my high school who admitted to me that I helped her get through AP Physics. We had very different political and religious ideologies. I would argue our connection was more intellectual and sexual than it was about having anything in common. If I had not broken things off with her, I feel I would not have learned the lessons I learned, and I would not be the man I am today. I would guess I might be filled with ideas of guilt and shame, wondering what could have been. My first wife. Married too soon, we didn't even take the time to get to know each other. Looking back, I suppose I was blinded by loneliness, and she was blinded by a desire to have children, having ended things for the second time with her ex-husband. We did okay enough in our marriage, sort of like best friends who lived together and occasionally had sex. I know now that she was never attracted to me. She even said so herself when she said seeing me the day I graduated from basic training, how skinny I was and my muscle tone gave her feelings she had not had for many years, never before with me. Things ended because we were completely different people with different hobbies and interests, as well as a sex life that had become a chore for both of us for the primary purpose of baby making rather than attraction and love. After our divorce, she remarried her ex-husband, making it her third time back with him. I'm happy for her. I truly am. We would both be miserable had we stayed together. Being with my wife now makes me the happiest I have ever been and glad I have chosen the path I have that brought me to her. I am glad things are not different. Story 28. My first love, I had to let go after the engagement but before the marriage. I wasn't ready for marriage yet. It would take me another 15 years before I matured enough to make the lifelong commitment to another person. She obviously didn't wait and went on with her own life. Now we are both much happier. She was a good woman, and I still think of her and what might have been if I met her when I was in a better place in life. Story 29. Yes, I do, but it's extremely complicated because she died 26 years ago. The relationship didn't run its course and blossom, then fade away, like many relationships do. It ended abruptly when it was at its peak for me, and the circumstances around it are difficult to handle because she committed suicide. So I occasionally go back there and engage with it, but it can be quite intense to do that. My view on it is complex, but broadly, it's hard not to look at my wife and especially my young son and think, all of it had to happen for you to be here, and for all of us to be here. And would I change it if I could? If that means my son ceasing to exist? No, never. I have written things about it and spoken some of them as poems on a YouTube channel. I've never shared them before, but hey, why not? If it's interesting to you, enjoy. This verse is called The Box.